So good morning, class 7 children. Welcome back after our winter break. So before vacations, we completed chapter number 16, water, and as well as we did the worksheet, NCERT worksheets of that chapter. So I hope each one of you had completed chapter number 16 in the notebooks. So afterwards, we are going to start with chapter number 17, Forest, Our Lifeline. So before going for the chapter forest, children, I want you to find out the misunderstood words of this chapter. So giving you some time, kindly continue finding the words of this chapter. And afterwards, we'll see the words from the chapter in between. Yes, Tanvi, first word is canopy. What this word is? Meaning of this word, kindly tell.
The branches of the tall trees of the forest form overhanging covering like a roof over the other plants. This is known as a canopy.
So can you give me the page number where it is written so that everybody can find it out? Kindly give the page number. And I want each one of you to open your books, children. Page number where it is written. Anyone among you, yes, Vansh?
Yes, ma'am. Page number is 209.
209. Page number 209. Kindly underline the definition of canopy. Canopy means, children, in the forest, you must have seen when the lot of trees are there, they just make a roof-like structure. And that roof-like structure is known as a canopy. Okay, Mahi. Next is crown. Okay, Lavish, you can tell what is crown?
Yes, ma'am. The branchy part of the tree above the stem is known as the crown of the tree.
Okay. The branchy part of the tree above the stem. Above the stem, the branches are there of the tree. That part is known as crown. Tell the page number, Lavish, and after that, Anya Jain, you will give. And after that, Abhigyan. Lavish, page number? Where you have read the crown, definition of crown, so that everybody can find it out. Just you have read the definition.
Then page number 209.
Page number 209, even the canopy and even for the crown. Okay, Anya Jain, next word is?
Next word is decomposers. The microorganisms which decompose the dead plants and animals to its components are known as decomposers.
Okay. Can I tell the page number so that everybody can write down?
Ma'am, 208.
So definition of decomposer is on page number 208. I hope children, everybody has find it out. Next, Abhigyan.
Yes, ma'am. And deforestation.
Yes.
Deforestation. It means clearing or cutting of trees.
Okay. Clearing or cutting of trees is known as deforestation. Can I have the page number?
Ma'am, it is not in the page number I have written.
Okay. Even you, simply you can write down the definition, clearing or cutting of the forest. Already you know the definition of this deforestation. Okay. Nishche. Next word is humus. Or Vedika, you can give Kavya for humus.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can I give
humus? Ma'am, can I?
Yes, Vedika.
The dead plants and animals tissue and convert them into a dark colored substance called humus.
Okay. The microorganisms convert the waste material into a dark color substance that is known as a humus. Can you tell the page number?
Ma'am, page number 212.
212. So children, kindly mark it. 212 page number. the definition of humus. Next is regeneration. Can anybody give me the...
Can I tell regeneration?
Yes.
Can I tell?
Okay, one by one you have to tell. Tell, Lavish.
Replacement of old and dead organisms by new ones is called regeneration.
Regeneration means replacement. Replacement from old to new one. Anybody else want to give the definition of this regeneration? Regeneration means replacement from old to new cells. If anybody else want to give the definition, you may give. Next is seed dispersal. Kavya? Kavya Thakur. Bhavya? Naman?
Ma'am, can I tell seed dispersal?
Yes, give.
The process of scattering seeds away from the parent plant is known as seed dispersal.
Simply, seed dispersal means scattering. Scattering of the seeds from the parent plant. Scattering of seeds from the parent plant is known as seed dispersal. Okay, good. Mukul Jain, Vansh Jain, will you give the answer of the next one? Soil erosion. Unmute and give the answer. Raise your hand, those who know the answer of soil erosion. Yes, Mahi. Nishche. Mukul. Okay, Mukul Jain, tell.
Then soil erosion is the replacement of the upper layer of the soil.
Okay, fine.
Can I tell, Vansh Jain?
Yes, Vansh Jain, tell.
The soil erosion is a natural process in which the topsoil of the field is carried away by physical sources like wind and water.
Okay, good. The washing away of the topsoil by the action of wind and water is known as soil erosion. Good. Next is understory. So what do you mean by understory? Yes, Anya Jain. And after that, Tanvi.
Trees have crowns of different forms and sizes. They form different horizontal layers in the forest. These are known as understories.
Understory. Okay, these are known as understory. Anya, can you share the page number?
Ma'am, 211.
211. Children, you may find the definition on page number 211. Yes, Tanvi, give the same question, this meaning, understory.
Understory. The different crowns of the trees have created different horizontal layers. This is known as understory.
Okay. So I hope, children, everybody has got the meaning of all these words. If any of the word is not clear to you, you may ask. Okay, children, after doing the key terms, let's continue with chapter number 17, Forests Are Lifeline. So in this chapter, what we are going to study, there is a visit to a forest by a professor and few of the kids. They are moving through the forest and they are awaring us with the different things which are present in the forest. And in the last part of this chapter, they are going to tell us that how forests are useful to us. Why we are saying that forests are our lungs, forests are our lifeline. Why they are known? They are also known as the green lungs. Why it is so? What they are providing us? Why we are saying that we need to plant more and more trees? What is the reason behind it? So all these things we are going to study in this chapter. And afterwards, the uses of the forest, and one thing more, why we are cutting the forest, the process of deforestation, what is the worst effect of deforestation on the soil. So all these things we are going to study in this chapter. So basically, this chapter is to spread awareness among the children so that we should plant more and more plants, more and more trees, more and more saplings, so that slowly it can convert into the forest and they can help us out. So this chapter is very interesting chapter, very simple chapter it is. Forest our lifeline. So I want one of you to start. Okay, Vedika, first you can start the chapter. And rest one by one, you have to read this chapter. Okay.
Can I start?
Yes.
Chapter 17, Forest, our lifeline. One evening, Bujo entered the park with an elderly person. He introduced him to his friends. Professor Ahmed was a scientist working in the university. The children started playing with Professor Ahmed, sat on a bench, while Professor Ahmed sat on a bench in the corner. He was tired as he had participated in the Golden Jubilee celebration of the town. After a while, the children also came and sat around him. They wanted to know about the celebrations. Professor Ahmed told them that after the cultural program, the senior people discussed the town's unemployment problem. A plan was proposed to put up a factory by clearing an area of the forest just outside the town. This would give the increasing population of the town a chance to get jobs. The children were very surprised when Professor Ahmed told them that many people had objected to this idea. This is because the forests serve as green lungs and water purifying system in nature, Professor Ahmed explained. The children were confused. Professor Ahmed realized that the children had not visited a forest. The children also wanted to know more about the forest, so they decided to visit it with Professor Ahmed.
Okay, children. So this was the beginning of the chapter. Now, Professor Ahmed, he was professor, assistant professor, senior professor, and the people and the few of the children, they were ready to visit to a forest. Now the visit to a forest start. Now they will be making us aware that what different things they have seen during their visit. So continue, Vaishjan.
Can I read?
Yes, okay, chalo. Bhavya start kare and after that Vaishjan will continue. Visit to a forest.
Visit to a forest. One Sunday morning, the children packed a few things like a knife, a hand lens, a stick, a notebook, and walked together through a forest trail near a village. On their way, they met Tibu, a young boy of their age group of nearby village, who was taking cattle for grazing along with his aunt. He was very ugly, running here and there to keep the herd together. When he saw the children, Tibu also started walking along with them. While his aunt went on a different path, as soon as they entered the forest, Tibu raised his hand and signaled them to keep quiet, because noise could disturb the animals living in the forest.
Okay, beta. Tibu, okay, Bhavya. Next one, Shan will continue. So he make the children quiet, yes, because the noise can disturb the animals. That's why he told them to remain quiet. Continue, beta. Next.
Okay, ma'am. Tibu then took them to a place at a height to show them the broad view of the forest. Children were surprised because they could not see any land. The different treetops had formed green cover over the land. However, the cover was not uniformly green. The environment was peaceful and a cool breeze was blowing. This made the children quite fresh and happy.
Okay.
Why?
So cool breeze was okay, but next is Nishchay can continue. The cool breeze was blowing, the environment where was very peaceful. So that's why the children were very happy and they were feeling fresh. Good. Next. Vedang Yadav, what is there in your hand? kindly keep it down. Continue with it.
While coming down, they got excited on hearing a sudden sound of birds and some noise from the top branches of the trees. Tibu told them to relax since it was a normal phenomenon here. Because of the children's presence, some monkeys had climbed higher up on the trees where they disturbed the birds, animals often giving this type of warning call to alert to other animals. Tibu also told that many other animals like boar, bison, jackals, porcupine, elephants live in the deeper areas of the forest.
Children, kindly underline this. This question you may write in the web chat form. The animals which live in the deeper areas of the forest. Kindly make a web chart of it.
Professor Ahmed cautioned children that they should not go deep into the forest.
Okay, beta. This is a word, caution. Caution, can I have the meaning of it? Professor Ahmed cautioned children. Kya matlab hai iska?
To give warning.
Yes, to give warning. They alert the children that they should not go deep into the forest. Okay, Vansh Sharma, you may continue with the next paragraph. Kindly write down children here.
Okay, ma'am.
Web chart, you have to make it. So which animals are there which are found in the deeper areas of the forest? Kindly continue with them.
Bojo and Pahali remember that they have studied about forest as an example of habitat in class 6. They could see now how the forest provides a home for many animals and plants. The land where the children were walking was uneven and covered with many trees. Tibu helped them to identify sal, teak, and semal, shisham, neem, palash, pick, hay, amla, bamboo, occasional. Professor Ahmed pointed out that there are several other trees, shrubs, herbs, and grasses in the forest. The forest floor and the trees were also covered with different types of creepers and climbers. The sun was barely visible through the leaves of the trees, making it quite dark inside the forest.
Okay, thank you, beta. So kindly underline, children. First of all, rest we'll take tomorrow. Kindly underline the different trees which are present inside the forest. Sal, teak, semal, shisham, neem, plash, etc. Kindly underline this paragraph. And one more question is there, children. It's very, very important. Why it is quite dark inside the forest? So kindly underline this paragraph even. The sun was barely visible through the leaves of the trees because there is quite dark in the forest. Why? Because the sun's rays does not...
Ma'am, can I tell this answer?
Okay, tell.
Ma'am, this is because of the canopy in the forest. The branches of the tall trees, it doesn't allow sunlight to go in the forest directly.
Yes, because the forest is quite dense. So the branches of the trees does not allow the light to enter. That's why there is quite dark in the forest. So kindly underline, children. One, this question is at the back exercise even. And two web charts. Different trees are in the forest and the animals which are found in the deeper regions of the forest. Kindly make these two web charts. Okay, rest will continue tomorrow from this activity 17.1.